Statistics and probability.
Good morning. Today we will discuss about test statistics. Watch and listen to this video lesson. Test statistic describes how closely the distribution of your data matches the distribution predicted under the null hypothesis of the statistical test you are using. We will learn today the different test statistics. One sample case. It examines whether the mean of the population is statistically different from a known or hypothesized value. The formula: when n, or the sample size, is greater than 30, we'll use the z-test, wherein our z is equal to the sample mean minus the population mean all over the population standard deviation divided by the square root of the sample size. That is for population mean. But if we're looking for z-test and for proportion, population proportion, so our formula will be z equals the sample proportion minus the population proportion divided by the square root of p multiplied to q all over n. And if our n is less than 30, we will use the t-test for one sample case, where t is equal to the sample mean minus the population mean all over the sample standard deviation divided by the square root of the sample size, wherein our degrees of freedom is equal to n minus 1. Two sample case. It compares the means of two groups, whether they are different or not. The formula: when n sub 1 and n sub 2 are greater than 30, or the sample size of the first group and the sample size of the second group are greater than 30. So we'll use the z-test of two sample case. Z-test for population mean has this formula, while the z-test for proportion has another formula. And if our sample size of our first group and second group are less than 30, and the variances are assumed equal, so we'll use the t-test for two sample case, and t is equal to more similar with the z of population mean. And our sp squared here is equal to the quantity of n first sample size, or sample size of the first group, minus 1 multiplied to the square of the standard deviation of our group 1, plus the product of the sample size subtracted to 1 of the second group multiplied to the square of the standard deviation of the second root all over the sample size of group 1 plus the sample size of group 2 minus 2, wherein our degrees of freedom is equal to the sum of the sample size of two groups minus 2. Paired sample case. It compares the means of two measurements taken from the same individual, object, or related units, like pre-test and post-test. The formula: t is equal to the summation of the difference, where d is the difference of the pre-test scores and the post-test scores, all over the square root of the product of the sample size and the summation of all, or the total of the square of the difference, minus the sum of the difference squared all over n minus 1, wherein our degrees of freedom is n minus 1. Pearson correlation. It measures the statistical relationship between two variables. And the formula is with R, the Pearson correlation R is equal to the product of the sample size and the total sum or the summation of X and Y minus the product of summation of X and summation of Y all over the square root of here the product of the quantity and the sample size summation of the X squared minus the summation of X squared. And a sample size multiplied to the summation of the y squared minus the summation of y then squared. Regression analysis. It is for the estimation of relationships between the dependent and independent variables. And the formula is similar to the slope intercept form wherein y is equal to a plus bx, wherein our b is from the formula of r and our a is the summation of y minus b times the summation of x all over n. We will learn all those different tests for this whole semester. Let's have some examples. On the average, 30% of the people afflicted with coronavirus die from it. A new treatment is being tried. Only 24% out of 200 patients die from it. Can we say that the new treatment is effective using 0.01 level of significance? Since n is greater than 30 and the situation compares the mean of the sample, which is our, or the proportion of our sample, which is 24%, to the known mean, which is the 30%. So, our appropriate test for this is z-test for one sample case. Now, our second example. 9 persons took a certain training to improve their IQ. The data are written below. Use 0.05 level of significance and determine whether or not the training was effective. Since the situation compares the means of two measurements, the before and after, taken from the same individual, so this is a test for t-test for paired sample case. Next, our third example. Two methods A and B were used to teach a high school algebra course. At the end of the semester, a random samples of final averages for the two methods were obtained. The sample information is given below. We have our method A and method B. Sample size of A is 55, for B is 40. Sample mean is 87, and sample size is 82, and sample standard deviation of 6 and 5. Using a 0.01 level significance, test whether the method is a more, if method A is more effective than method B. Since the problem compares the means of two groups and the n is greater than 30, so the test statistics is z-test for two sample cases. Lastly, our fourth example. To determine which type of fertilizer, X or Y, is more effective in increasing the average yield of a certain potatoes planted on the same ground, a farmer recorded the yields of potatoes as shown below. Is there a significant difference between the mean yield of the potatoes using fertilizer X or Y? Use 0.05 level of significance and assume the population variances to be equal. Since the problem compares the means of two groups and n is less than 30, so the test statistic is t-test for two sample cases. It is now your turn to answer. Determine the appropriate test statistic of the problem. The owner of a company that sells a particular tempura claims that the average capacity of a small pack is 250 milligrams and a standard deviation of 2.5 milligrams. A random sample of 60 small packs of tempura have a mean mass of 245 milligrams. At 0.05 level of significance, is there sufficient evidence to support the claim of the owner? If you have some suggestions, comments, and queries regarding our topic, just give your thoughts under the comment section or directly ask me through Messenger. Thank you. See you next topic.